What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel. Back with another video. Back with another question. What are we going to do about the current state of Black culture? And I know I get a lot of pushback when I talk about Black culture. People say this is not, the things you are pointing out about society are not Black culture. That's inward culture. I've heard it before, right here in the comments. And I know, as much as anyone, there's a difference between Black folks and N-words. It's okay to draw a distinction. It's okay to declare yourself different from them folks who can't control their emotions, from them folks who are uneducated, from them folks who pump negative rap music into their headphones 24/7 and get on Instagram and TikTok and feed their eyes with negative images that affect their own psyche. And it manifests itself in their own actions. And they end up in situations that we see in blue cities all across the country, where folks will just walk into a store, grab something off the shelf, and walk out. Not just grab one item, but grab a whole shelf full of items and fill a garbage bag and walk out. Who taught you how to be this person? Who taught you how to conduct yourself this way? Who is advocating for policies that allow these actions to flourish? I think we know the answer to that question, although a lot of us don't want to admit it, because a lot of us vote for it. Take a look at what happened in Philadelphia just last night, as these young people entered random stores and got five-finger discounts on whatever they wanted. Disregarded the laws, did what they wanted to do. Check this out, y'all.
Breaking news to get to tonight. Video showing people breaking into stores right in Center City, Philadelphia. Officers saying these people were not part of the protesters who were upset following a judge's dismissal of all charges against former Philadelphia police officer Mark Dial.
Yeah, people can be seen carrying arms full of merchandise after breaking into this Foot Locker on Chestnut Street.
Monday night, I'm Gray Hall with Shari Williams. The big story tonight on Action News is breaking news of reports of looting tonight on the streets of Philadelphia.
Well, this does come hours after city officials called for calm following charges being dismissed against Officer Mark Dial in the shooting death of Eddie Irizarry. Action News' Chris Dialetto joining us here live now in Center City with more. And Christy, police stressing that those we're seeing doing these acts, not necessarily a part of the protest from earlier.
And that's right, Shari. And I want to set the scene here on Walnut Street because it pretty much looks like a labyrinth of yellow crime scene tape. Now, from what we can see, it looks like 15th Street all the way to 18th Street have been blocked off. And within the confines of those blocks are stores like the Apple Store that were hit by looters. Now, like you mentioned, police say that they don't believe the individuals responsible are tied to that peaceful protest from earlier. I did speak to Commissioner Stanford by phone, and he says that the individuals that have been detained range from teens to young adults, and they have even recovered one weapon. They're still processing a lot of the people that have been detained, but they don't believe that they were tied to that protest, that they were just in fact trying to take advantage of what was happening at City Hall. But again, I want to go to some video because they targeted a lot of stores here in both Center City and Rittenhouse. This is the Foot Locker along Chestnut Street, and you can see crowds of people running in and out of the stores carrying merchandise, clothes, shoes, BMWs all weaving in and out of traffic on Chestnut Street. And then we even spoke to a witness who was in Rittenhouse. I'm going to go to this video because this is video outside of the Lululemon store on Walnut. A witness says that she and her friends were sitting across the street at A Bar at 18th and Walnut when they suddenly saw a crowd of teens swarm the doors and then began looting the store.
Saw a bunch of people like just go into the Lululemon, clothes everywhere.
What was running through your mind?
I'm sitting by a window. I'm just gonna like look the other way. This is, yeah, it's kind of scary. Yeah.
The Apple store looks pretty cleaned out.
Really?
Yeah, except for like computer monitors, but like all the Apple Watches, iPhones look pretty.
What do you make of that when you see all of this happening?
I mean, well, we watched like the Lululemon thing happen, and that was concerning just because it looked like a lot of people got arrested at first, but they kind of let everybody go.
Wow, okay.
So I mean, I would say like 30 plus people ran the opposite direction away from the scene, and then everything died down.
Yeah.
Again, this is a live look at the Apple store where police investigators are still trying to process this scene. They have multiple scenes that they are at. Again, the Lululemon store, the Foot Locker. We also heard about a Nordstrom Rack. Again, I did speak with Commissioner Stanford. He said that they do not believe that these individuals that were behind the looting are tied to the protests that happened at City Hall, that they were just trying to take advantage of that situation. They are still trying to process all of the people that they have detained, and that is going to take some time. So we won't even have a real number of how many people were taken into custody or being processed until probably tomorrow morning. They also did recover a weapon, but we will have more information on that as we continue to follow this developing story. Live here in Rittenhouse, Chris Stiletto for Action News at 10 on PHL 17. Gray and Shari.
Y'all, this is a problem. And this problem in particular begins in the home. These are young people. They only got a couple adults in the crowd. Most of these were minors, young people. And the stores that they looted can tell you a lot about the psychology of these individuals. They went into Foot Locker. Why? Because they wanted to be able to stunt on their friends in new kicks. These kicks that are made in China by little babies in sweatshops. Cost you $10 a pair. But here in America, you paying $200 for that pair. And instead of these young people seeing the value of that shoe as the $10 that it cost to manufacture, they're looking at the $200, $250 price tag that they would have to pay here in America, saying, hey, I'd never be able to afford those shoes on my own. So let me take advantage of this opportunity to go steal them and stunt through the neighborhood. And you know who's waiting for you when you stunt in them sneakers? The little jack boys who walk around the neighborhood with pistols, with Glocks, with switches, waiting to up that pole and make you come up out them shoes in the middle of the street. What is going on with Black culture, I asked, because as I watched this video, I saw Black faces in and out of these different stores in Philadelphia, taking what they wanted, not what they needed, because they had shoes on their feet when they went in there. Can't be said that they needed those shoes. Nah, they wanted those shoes. They took on a mob mentality, busted through glass, ran in there and took what they wanted. And I have to ask, where are the parents? Boy, where is your daddy? Where is that man to lay down the rod of correction in your life? and keep you from doing things like this that may land you behind bars all over a stupid decision for some sneakers, overpriced sneakers that the manufacturer paid a few dollars to have created, up the price exponentially and charged you $250. You knew you couldn't afford it. But what I want to know is why you valued it so much. Why was it worth so much to you to risk your freedom, to risk your life for some doggone tennis shoes? Again, I ask, what has happened to Black culture that we think it's worth it to risk it all to look like something? Living in the hood, we got some new sneakers. Living in the hood, got some new jeans. And we think, in our warped mentality, we've been conditioned to think that these material items are things of value. No, not education. No, not careers. No, not honesty. Not living a productive life. But just let me stunt for a few minutes. Even if this few minutes cost me the rest of my life, just let me stunt. What's going on, y'all? What's going on with Black culture, with Black society? Where I see news stories like this, but I hear no one who looks like me speaking out against it. In fact, the mayor of Chicago is constantly making excuses for this kind of behavior. And I say, what's going on with our culture, with our people? Like, we would make excuses for this mob behavior. These people are acting like animals. And then you want to cry racism when someone speaks the truth about what they see. I don't know these kids. All I know is what I see on camera. I can only describe what I see. They're acting unruly. They're acting uncouth. They're acting like savages. All over some sneakers? a little synthetic leather, a little rubber glued together by some child in a sweatshop in China? And you think that's worth your life? And y'all get mad at me when I talk about these rappers who promote this kind of culture, who turn against God openly, who have sold their souls to the devil and the industry, and promote the degradation of society. You get mad at me when I point this stuff out? These kids are on their way to a jail cell. They don't even have the sense to mask up and glove up. They just feel like they can walk into some man's business and take those things that he's worked hard for and covet them as their own. Just to put them on the gram and say, look what I got. Hey, y'all, I don't know who needs to hear this, but the police are on the gram. The FBI is on the gram. All of these three-letter agencies are on this platform looking at content. They see y'all. So when you get that knock on the door and they put your child in cuffs and you're faced with that reality that you ain't been doing your job as a parent, I hope that God has mercy on your situation and you see it as a turning point to do better in the hood and love your children and put forth the effort. Yeah, we know it's hard work to raise a child, especially in hood conditions. That's what you signed up for when you birthed that child. We hope that you embrace your obligations as a parent and do your best to turn these kids around. Because this, whether it be in Philly, in Brooklyn, in Atlanta, in San Francisco, in Oakland, in LA, this is unacceptable. And for us to accept it as Black culture? Nah, bro. There's plenty of people out here who look like me, who earn like me, who got college degrees like me, who's saying, I ain't part of this. These little people right here who act like this, nah, I ain't part of that. Separate them from me. Because we don't support them. They acting like animals, roving through the streets, breaking in stores, looting and stealing. You got shoes on your feet, bro. Ain't no excuse for you to walk in there, break through the window, and steal these folks' shoes. What do y'all think about this? Because the stigma is heavy on the Black community when incidents like this occur. And you got people out there like Black Lives Matter and all these different organizations that try to make excuses for this. Nah, bro, there's no excuse. This is degenerate activity. And I know I'm going to get the hate. They going to call me a raccoon for saying this. But call me what you want. I ain't going to tell you what I think about it on them folks' platform. But I don't support this at all. And if you support it, I suggest you unsubscribe to this channel. You done found the wrong place. We don't do that here. We promote education. We promote entrepreneurship. We don't support this at all over here. Like the video. Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation. You know, and like I always say, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.